the Republic Day in 1950, nothing actually registered in our mind in regard to what's happening.
I was just completing my basic education before joining the Air Force.
At the age of 16, you're footloose and fancy free, mostly in your own world, doing your own things.
Initially, as kids, we would say a holiday.
One by one, you know, we started to get a feel of the whole thing. That's because, you know, most of these visuals were through documentaries. We got to seeing the first parade along the Rajpath and other things. And can you imagine that parade as they had concept, you know, which is being followed even today? I recall all of us, I mean, you know, being lined up, all little guys, and then, you know, we had our Gandhi caps on, and then I remember being led with a flag in the front.
The flags and everything, we respected. And when we put it up, it was with an emotion. Not it is because, oh, it's a fashion. So everybody is doing, so I'm also doing. It was not that. It was quite patriotic. And that has remained even today with us.
We used to, at the drop of a hat, get into this procession mode. It's, all of the little fellows would be lined up, and then we all had to go along, march. We had various things like Inqilab, Zindabad, and all the kind of stuff we used to go along with. And it was good times.
The celebrations were not like only dancing. Celebrations was with definitely some kind of emotions for us.
Things happening which we, as little kids, you know, we used to wonder what's happening around here.
There'll be no more viceroys and all those things. And our people are becoming the president and the prime minister. It was told to us in school by our teachers in such a way that we did understand that after all these years, we are going to have our own people.
I remember the names of each one of the ministers who got named at that time. So it was a big thing for us all to know, hey, K.T. Basham is going to be the law minister.
Then, of course, the later part, you're taking part in that. That made you very proud.
The best thing that the British left for us is the democracy.
What is democracy? Nobody knows, because we have not experienced anything under the British rule or under a foreign power.
So what we have been doing for the last 60 years, everybody thinks that we wasted our time and all that kind of stuff. It wasn't an easy thing to build this country, this nation. Because, you know, if you looked at the kind of odds that we were against of those days, you know, with absolutely hostile Western world.
I'm as a person very positive about the country. It has great potential.
I think, you know, we can see beautiful things happening in this country, because we can boast of some of the most intelligent people.
I mean, children of today have got lots and lots of amenities and lots of knowledge also about other things because of computers and other things which we didn't even think that it can ever come.
I say that I celebrate today's youth. I mean, you know, I tell people, I said, look, you must sort of celebrate it, because, you know, it's a tremendous, tremendous pool of energy that we have.
Girls and boys going abroad. I said, why is it that you all settle down there? You go for your studies, because if the cream of the society goes away in another country, which is already developed, then our country will remain that, because you are not coming back to our country to give that back to our country.
I chose to stay behind in this country. I said, this is the country where I was born, this is the country which has made me, and this is the country where I'm going to live and then serve.
Long years ago, we made a tryst with destiny, and now...
First Prime Minister of India.
I don't know.
Kaun hai pehla Prime Minister of India ka?
Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru.
Okay, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru.